Today, let's explore filters in ASP.NET Core MVC. We're going to explore what filters are and the different types of filters with some real-world scenarios. Woo-hoo! Let's get started. In ASP.NET Core MVC, we use filters to run some custom logic before or after specific stages in the request processing pipeline. For example, for tasks like authentication, logging, and exception handling, there is some repetitive code that needs to be applied to multiple controllers or actions. Instead of writing repetitive code in multiple controllers or actions, filters provide a clean and reusable way to handle cross-cutting concerns. Now, let's look at the different types of filters and how they work in real-world scenarios. By the way, if you want to copy the code that shows in this video, there's a link in the description below. Okay, let's get started. First, authorization filters. This filter will run before other filters to determine whether a user is authorized to access a resource. Okay, now we have this scenario. For some specific controllers like setting controller, error log controller, and email log controller, only admins can access these controllers. Yes, we can write authorize roles equal to admin on the controllers to ensure that only accounts which have the admin role can access the controller. But what if we need a more custom scenario? For example, only admins who have registered for more than 1 year can access certain controllers. Or only users who are on a pro subscription plan can access the controllers or actions related to pro features. For these custom and more complex authorization scenarios, we can create custom authorization filters. Now let's write the code to create a custom authorization filter for the pro subscription scenario. I'll name it Pro Subscription Filter. It implements iAuthorization Filter, or we can also use iAsync Authorization Filter. Then, we need to inject ApplicationDB context to access user subscription data from the database. Now, let's dive into the onAuthorizationAsync method. This method gets executed automatically when the filter is applied. So first, we check if the user is authenticated. If the user is not logged in, they are redirected to an access denied page. After we ensure the user is logged in, we can get the user's ID from their claims. If we can't retrieve the user ID, we again redirect the user to the access denied page. Okay, now let's query the database to get the user's subscription plan. If the user doesn't have a pro subscription, they are redirected to the subscription page and informed that they need to upgrade their plan to access the feature. Now, the custom filter is completed. We can apply it to the controller now. Let's say we have Pro Controller, Exclusive Controller, and Advanced Controller. All three of them are only accessible to the users who subscribe to the Pro plan. We can apply the Pro Subscription filter on top of the controllers like this: Service Filter, Type Off, Pro Subscription filter. This way, we don't need to rewrite the code in every action or controller, but just apply the same filter to them. Next, resource filters. Resource filters run after authorization. Let's see an example. Imagine you have a blog page that fetches data from a database. For pages like blog, news, FAQ, or help center articles, typically, these are the pages that the data is updated periodically, not updated every second. So, instead of querying the database on every page refresh, we can use a resource filter to cache the response for a few minutes, and it won't impact user experience since the data is not updated every second. This will reduce database load and improve performance. Okay, let's see the code example. Let's create a cache resource filter class and implement iResource filter. We need to inject the iMemory cache. Set how many minutes we want to cache the page for. In onResource executing, which means before executing the controller action, we check if the response is cached. If yes, we return the cached response immediately, skipping the controller logic. When onResource executed, which means after the request is processed, we store the response in the cache for 5 minutes. Now that we have our resource filter, we need to register it in the program file. We enable in-memory caching first, then register the cache resource filter like this. All right, now it's time to apply this cache resource filter to the blog page. Add service filter, type off, cache resource filter on top of the index action in the blog controller. The first time the page loads, it fetched the fresh blog post. Then for every time we refresh the page within the subsequent 5 minutes, it will get the cached response, making it faster and reducing the database calls. Next, action filters. Action filters run before and after an action executes. Let's look at an example of using a custom action filter. Imagine you are building a web app. Every page also needs to display the profile picture. It's a nightmare to write the same code again and again for every action method to fetch the profile picture URL from the database and display it for every view page, right? So how do we set it once and reuse the profile picture data for all the pages? Let's create a custom action filter for it. I'll name it Profile Picture Filter and implement iAction Filter. When each action is executing, we get the current user's profile picture URL and set it to a view bag like this. Now, we register our profile picture filter in program file like this. Now, the view bag will be available in every view without needing to set it manually in each controller action. In the login partial, we can use viewbag.profilePictureURL to display the profile picture. If any other view pages need it, we can use the same view bag to access it too. Filter type number 4, exception filters. Imagine we're building a web app. In some action method, we forgot to put the try-catch block. When an exception error occurs, no try-catch block means that there are unhandled exceptions. This is where the exception filter comes in. Exception filters will execute when an unhandled exception occurs. We can create a custom exception filter to show a different message based on the exception type. Let's create the class. I'll name it Custom Exception Filter and implement iException Filter. Then, based on the exception type, we can set different friendly error message. When the exception is caught, we'll return the custom error view page. We can also set the error message in view data. Now, let's create the custom error view page to show the error message. Lastly, register the custom exception filter in the program file. Now, when an exception is unhandled, this custom exception filter will catch the exception, and the web app will display this kind of friendly error message to the user. Filter type number 5, result filters. Result filters run immediately before and after the execution of an action result. So it's useful for monitoring the performance metrics. Now let's create the custom result filter called Performance Monitor Filter and implement iResult Filter. Next, inject the iLogger to log the performance data. We also need the stopwatch field to help us measure the execution time of the action result. Next, onResultExecuting method is called right before the action result starts executing, so we start the stopwatch here. Then, log the start of the action. OnResultExecuted method runs right after the result is executed, so stop the stopwatch here. Then, log the elapsed time in milliseconds. Log the status code too. Lastly, don't forget to register the custom result filter in the program file. Now, when we run the project, we can see the log information from the console output. This way, we know how long each action took to execute and whether it was successful or not. So, let's say you are thinking of two different pieces of code that can achieve the same thing, but you're not sure which method is better in terms of performance. Then you can use this performance monitor filter to investigate and compare the execution time. That's a wrap. These are the 5 different filters that you'll find helpful for your projects. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to like this video and subscribe to the channel. See you in the next video.